The Arting Health for Impact is part of a three-nation program running now in India, Botswana, and South Africa.
I think it's very important to look at mental well-being in a workplace setting because we spend more than 8 hours a day in a workplace. And if we don't take care of mental health in that setting, we are losing out on 1/3 of our lives. Mental health obviously helps us not only to perform better in our own work, but it also contributes to the overall productivity of the company that we are working in, and which eventually leads to better productivity and economic value for the country as a whole.
A first of its kind workshop on workplace mental stress, bringing together art and health, was organized at the George Institute for Global Health India, with participants drawn from various professional organizations in Delhi. The objective being to build capacity of these participants to undertake similar programs on addressing work stress in their respective organizations.
Ideas, some ways in how to deal with it in a better way, some legal ramifications which Niti will be talking about, which are some good practices that may be followed within the organization. And we are happy.
When I count to three, everyone has to jump.
Okay.
Everyone has to jump. Okay, good. Everyone can sit down. So the whole purpose of this exercise is that we have defined social norms and we don't want to step out of it.
But I think at the end of the day, we all are part of that society who end up making judgments about our own selves, about others.
That no, I want to tell the world that I have a mental illness. No, it's a very personal choice. If you want to,
yes.
As I go along, though, this does seem a little HR focused. However, if there is anything that you, from your own empowering perspective and going back perspective, you could definitely talk about.
An open house was encouraged with engaging team activities after every session to help participants deconstruct the challenges and coping mechanisms relating to workplace mental stress.
And I think this is one of the most identified program with an X factor, which one could definitely, as a professional having to come from this field, think of it as an area which could contribute a lot of knowledge and new out-of-the-box kind of a thinking, which could kind of contribute to a lot of things in terms of legislative formulations, initiatives, and also doing things with great action on field. So I would strongly recommend that these kind of programs would be an eye-opener to a lot of new initiatives, and I wish them all the very best in terms of the new initiative and strategic action and their contribution to the global betterment of this particular area of rising epidemic.
This is the first platform wherein I have seen people are working to root out the work-related stress. We all have been facing the same issue at each and every office, but none of us have taken an initiative to discuss it in a group. So I think it's a great initiative taken by the management.
The most important takeaway for me from this workshop has been how important it is not to trivialize mental health at the workplace. Although there is awareness now, more than what it was earlier in society, but there is still a long way to go for all of us to cover the distance and create a safe environment and safe space for everyone.
For the program's engagement event at the Select City Walks Arcade, a short play on workspace stress was performed in collaboration with the kids from Jamghat, an organization which works on resettlement of homeless children. Following the workshop on workspace stress, a Healthy Mind street art public engagement event was organized at the Select City Walks Arcade to engage with the office goers at the mall on workspace mental stress using art, theater, and films.
So involved in this artwork that you're looking just behind us, which is basically we did this to create awareness about corporate mental stress.
So
This is the mixture of graffiti and doodle. So we have made all these chakras. The first, the main attraction, the middle one, chakra is the name we have written over there, Vishwadhamma.
Physical activity badha sakte hain jab bhi aap kuch aur bhi nahi kar sakte walk pe chali jaiye exercise kijiye wo nahi kar sakte skip the rope whatever ya lift nahi use kar rahe hain stairs use kijiye is tarah ki cheeze aap kar sakte
hain my institute's first time or not but definitely this is a good starting point I think informal discussions beyond the official space of an office helps.
Talk about mental health issues, but generally we see that people wouldn't like to talk about mental health issues because again there is a lot of stigma attached to it.
In the society, and there could be something called as self-stigma wherein people are talking to themselves saying that oh, they are getting demoralized, they themselves feel that okay, this is not, I cannot do this.
Mystic image of what a good person or a great student is supposed to be like, which no one can really achieve, and when you're not able to achieve that, you feel okay, I'm unworthy, I'm little, something like
that. Every person, that one person is going through something and we just don't understand mental health, like the seriousness of, about it. We just think that, oh, it's ye pagal hai, the word pagal.
While the kids of Jamghat acted as pillars for the event by two very energetic performances, attracting the select city walk crowds.
The concept of this project was using art as a medium, street art as a medium, the expression forward to the public to actually try and remove the stigma attached to the whole mental health and workplace stress in particular.
I'm interested in arts and health, and this is a very good initiative by George Institute and India Alliance to communicate mental health, especially work stress and depression, to the public. So it was a very innovative way of using street art and also theater.